Hey, what's up guys? Welcome back to my channel. Rahul here for RoamerRealm. I work as a marine engineer on merchant ships, and in today's video, I'll try to cover the basic explanation for the dismantling, overhaul, and assembly of the main engine fuel injectors. Let's go. To begin with, let me give you a short background. In a marine engine, depending on the size of the bore, each unit or cylinder can be fitted with two or three fuel injectors. The main job of the fuel injector is to inject fuel into the combustion chamber. The timing, duration, and efficiency of the fuel injection plays a vital role in the overall combustion efficiency during the engine cycle. On your screen, you can see a fuel injector which has recently been removed from one of the units from the main engine. It's placed next to the special tools which we use to disassemble it. I will discuss about the special tools in a bit. For dismantling, I'll be using the electric drilling machine that we have in our workshop. I have already set it lower, the platform. And this is the standard attachment for gripping the drill bits. Talking about special tools, they're just two actually. One of them is the holder, which will go onto these screws, like that. And the second one is called the compression piece. It's basically a cylindrical piece with a flat base and a conical inner profile. The flat side is supposed to be used here, like this. And the conical piece will go on the taper here so that it's going to fit, like that. This is a normal hook spanner which will be used to loosen the lock nut when it'll be the time for the nut to be loosened. And finally, the hammer is just in case. Normally the lock nut should come out by hand, but a few taps by the hammer may be required because the threads may have traces of fuel oil and that's sticky. So, the idea is to take the injector, flip it upside down, and then place it here on the vise. First, of course, I will put the special tool. Clamp it, put the injector on top of it. Then on top will be the conical piece going. Like that. It's going to be clear as we move on into the video. Basically, once the injector is in place, I will turn the handle this way to press the injector. It's actually the spring inside the injector which is getting compressed. And once compressed, the lock nut can then be loosened. So the injector is in place now. I had to change this piece because the vertical clearance was not enough to fit the injector in place. Anyway, so the special tool is clamped in the vise. The fuel injector is resting on the tool. There's a small clearance between the injector and the vise. I have plugged this because when I will press the injector, oil will come out. It's already coming out because the injector is upside down. This is the conical piece in place. So now when I press this down, the whole thing is going to move down a little bit and the lock nut will be easy to loosen. It's a normal right-hand thread, so shouldn't be difficult. Normally, you'll need two people to do this job. One keeps the injector pressed down while the other loosens the lock nut. So now I'm pressing it, and remember, tapping gently using a hammer on the hook spanner should be enough. Loosen 2 to 3 turns on the lock nut while keeping the injector pressed. Although it's not visible on the screen, but I have been holding the handle down and kept pressing the injector throughout. Once 2 to 3 turns are done, I'll let go of the handle and the lock nut remains free, and then it can be loosened all the way. After cleaning all the parts, I've arranged them as an exploded view. For your reference, this is a fuel injector from a Man BMW 8S80ME electronic engine. Okay, so the first component is the fuel nozzle. A quick visual check for any signs of corrosion, scratches, or damage. Next, the spindle guide. A quick visual check here as well. Note that the spindle guide has a mark. During assembly, this mark needs to be in line with the recess mark on the fuel nozzle. Additionally, there's also a small locating pin on the spindle guide which helps keep the fuel nozzle in place. Thank you. After inspecting the spindle guide, next is the cutoff shaft, followed by the thrust piece, followed by the foot. Don't get stressed with the many different names. Remember that these are all internal parts and they're all highly polished surfaces. And right now we're just doing a visual check, looking for any abnormalities. This is the NRV, that is the non-return valve. I've further dismantled this to check the condition of the components inside. Very often the spring inside is either damaged or broken. This one looks fine though. However, the contact surface, which we'll seal against the valve head, seems a bit worn out. It's not that bad, so I've decided to use it for now. We'll see how it performs during the injector testing. About the thrust spindle, the old one was damaged beyond repair, so I'm gonna use a new one. A few scratches here and there can be lapped and polished, but a damage that's so deep shouldn't be repaired for reuse. The small discs that you see, they are for adjusting the injection pressure. Next is the injector head, and it is really important to inspect the inner surface where the O-rings are sealing. Many times I've seen that this is the surface which develops a step kind of formation on the inner walls, and eventually it leads to an oil leak. Also check the condition of the face of the surface where the non-return valve will be sealing against. It should be smooth and without any cracks, surface defects or dents. Pay attention to the threads and the inner surfaces as well, because here is where the high pressure fuel pipe will be connected when the injector is in operation. Alright, so those are all the components, and oh yeah, for lubricating during the overhaul, I'm gonna use two things. First, Molycoat or molybdenum disulfide, and second, normal lubricating oil. This can be main engine system oil, cylinder lube oil, all are fine. While each of the internal components are important, I want to specifically show you how to overhaul a non-return valve, and also the correct way to assemble the cutoff shaft with the spindle guide and fuel nozzle, because these are more critical than the others. To do that, first, clamp the body onto the table vise. Be generous while using the lubricant, because the idea is to keep the valve in service for the next 8,000 hours when it will become due for the routine overhaul again. All the parts should be smoothly fitting into each other. If anything is getting stuck or is hard to assemble, check the surfaces again. Another thing I want to say, if the instruction manual says to apply Molycoat on certain surfaces, only use Molycoat and not copper slip or any other special high temperature grease, etc. Also remember that Molycoat is a smooth component and does not have any grits, for example as found in copper slip. So if the surface smoothness is of absolute essence, do not use copper slip. After the initial assembly, the final step happens on the drilling machine platform. Mount the special tool on top of the non-return valve as shown, and press the entire assembly down using the drilling machine handle. Note that the spring is really strong, so you will really need to press hard to compress it. When both the surfaces join together, that's when you can say that the non-return valve is assembled and ready for pressure testing. The special tool is common and will be used for the assembly of nozzle valve with the cutoff shaft and the spindle guide. Believe it or not, on some ships I've seen where people don't even dismantle the non-return valve. They say that it's sealed from the factory and cannot be dismantled on board. It is incorrect. It can be dismantled on board, and for me, one definitely needs to dismantle it and inspect all the internal parts, especially the spring. Start with the same, cleaning, inspecting and then lubricating the surfaces with Molycoat and lube oil. Just like with a non-return valve, Here also, all the internal parts should be interacting smoothly with each other, and nothing should be stuck or feel hard to move. Also, take necessary precautions to ensure that no dirt from the forced ventilation, for example, or any fine strand of fabric from the cleaning rag, etc., goes in and sticks to these surfaces. Add a few drops of lubricating oil and then insert the cutoff slide inside the spindle guide. Add some lubricating oil and exercise the components as shown so as to ensure that they are moving freely. The word exercise here basically means to move it back and forth a few times. If all the surfaces are fine, you'll see that the cutoff slide starts to slide down by itself under gravity inside the spindle guide. After this, insert the thrust piece by hand. It'll only go so much by hand, and you'll have to tap it with a mallet so that it sits properly. Once again, check that the cutoff slide is free to move and is not stuck. The fuel nozzle goes next. Remember, check the alignment marks. Also remember to align the locating pin with the groove on the fuel nozzle. First, I tap it gently in place so that it won't fall off. And then for the final tightness, we'll use the special tool and the drilling machine. Like this. Mount the special tool on the fuel nozzle and then press it down using the drilling machine handle. That's it. This component is ready as well. The rest of the assembly is quite straightforward. Just do it in the reverse order as dismantling. I also give the valve body a quick wipe after assembly to remove all the old traces of oil, lubricant, etc. so that the leaks, if any, are easier to spot during the next step, which is the pressure testing of the fuel injector. Alright, question for you. Would you like me to make another video about the pressure testing of the fuel oil injectors? Post a yes or no in the comments and I'll get my lead from there. So I've tried to explain the basics about the dismantling, overhaul and assembly of the fuel injector. If you have a follow-up question about this topic or any other topic about ships and machinery, feel free. Ask me, post it as a comment and I'll try to clear your doubt in the comments itself. But if the topic is too big, probably I'll make another video about it. Speaking of video, if you enjoyed this one, give it a like. Doing that tells YouTube that this video has value. And for more such informative content, please subscribe to my channel. As always, thanks for watching, keep exploring. This is Rahul for RoamerRealm, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye.